I don't really remember what brought me to Audubon initially. It's been a part of my life and my childhood for so long that I don't really remember the initial experience. I remember visiting the banding station at some point, maybe in late elementary school or middle school. And I remember going on Walk the Wetlands hikes. And I remember somebody sharing their Fig Newtons with me.
So Ryan and I, we both joined the Master Naturalist class led by Kate Hogan. And there we met our wonderful classmates. It was a year-long event that kind of opened our eyes to a lot of the work that Denver Audubon as an organization did throughout the community and their impact. And that was something that I thought was pretty neat and wanted to be a part of as well. So, you know, after we graduated and finished our course, just felt right to be able to also give back to the community as well through some of the volunteer work that, you know, have been presented to us. So. That's kind of how it all started.
I've always been excited about environmental education and getting people outdoors and allowing people to see nature in new ways. And becoming a community naturalist through Denver Audubon has allowed us to get out there in our community and really spend time with people that maybe didn't see birds or trees or the natural world the way that they might see it after spending time with someone that shows them these things in a new way. So learning how to interpret our surroundings and really bring that to light in the eyes of other people, I think, has really been an important part of what I've taken away from Denver Audubon.
I'd known about Denver Audubon for many years through volunteering and conservation organizations in Douglas County. In contemplating retirement 3 years ago, I started to look into Denver Audubon as one of the educational opportunities that I wanted to pursue. I started with beginning birding, with a vague idea about the Master Birding Program beginning in 2019.
What brought me to Denver Audubon was Marilyn Rhodes. My wife and I went on a birding trip with Marilyn Rhodes to Red Rocks, and she was so enthusiastic about the birds there. She was so knowledgeable about them. And she was connected to Denver Audubon. Later, she went through their Master Birder program, and listening to what she was doing there got me very excited about joining that as well. And so I'd have to credit Marilyn Rhodes with getting me to Denver Audubon.
Why do I volunteer with Denver Audubon? I love the programming. I think it's amazing that anytime I bring a friend or a family member, they always pick up some little thing that just instills a greater interest in the outdoor world and makes them want to engage in habitat protection.
Denver Audubon's philosophy and work in conserving our natural world is the right thing to do for our planet. I believe that we all need to work to preserve our planet and make sure that Earth is available to our future generations. I want my grandchildren to know nature, to enjoy wild birds, to admire wild mammals, and even to enjoy a day on the trout stream. To meet that vision, we must work to preserve our environment and heal the many wounds that mankind has already inflicted. Simply, I want to be part of the solution, not the problem.
Why do I volunteer at Denver Audubon? You know, we're living in a world where global climate change is real, where there are so many threats to animals, to our environment, and I want to make a difference. I want to make a difference at a global level, but I also want to make a difference at a local level. And Denver Audubon gives me the opportunity to connect with people who really can help me feel like I'm making a difference here in the Denver area.
I participated in the Master Birding Program, which provided so many connections for me within the community. It was sort of like the fundamental turning point for like how I understood the birding community in Colorado and the people I knew and how I sort of became the birder I am today. It gave me the courage to go and get a degree in biology, which I was terrified of doing, but I did. And it provided me my first job out of high school as well at the Front Range Birding Company.
What do I like most about Denver Audubon? The people. the people who care about birds, the people who care about bird environments. For a long time, I thought I was the only idiot who would drive down the road, see something flying, and stop my car and get out and try to find what it is. Actually, I come off as a neophyte compared to most of the people there. I love the enthusiasm.
So I volunteer with Denver Audubon because it was such a foundational organization in my childhood and sort of encouraging me to go into the field of biology and ornithology, especially because in middle school and high school, I wasn't very science oriented. I struggled in math and biology and whatnot. But I think between meeting people like Meredith and then all of the educators at Audubon and all of the citizen science projects that they participate in, it really helped me understand that like being a scientist didn't mean I needed to be some sort of magic math wizard. I could just be, you know, who I needed to be, and if I needed to struggle with math, that was okay, because a lot of people do. But in addition, it really just helped me realize that, I don't know, being part of a community is really important for personal growth because it allows a lot of support when maybe you're not feeling like you can do something. And I wanna provide that for other people, especially kids growing up.
Forward to doing with Denver Audubon this year, learning more birds. I am a solid intermediate birder, but the more time I spend with master birders, the more I realize that there's so much more to learn, and I love it. How did birding help me through the pandemic last year? First and foremost, just slowed me down, let me, you know, go outside and recognize the nature around me, a little bit of entertainment. The pandemic helped me get some time to do the naturalist training. So it was really cool to learn more about the flora and the fauna and the ecology of the area. And then one thing I was able to do last year with friends was take walks, and it was really cool to share the information that I learned through that program last year.
What's your favorite bird? Well, I think it changes. It feels like my favorite bird is the bird in front of me that just taught me something new. Right now, we are seeing multiple brown creepers in our backyard for the first time, and I find them fascinating to watch. How they fly to the bottom of our juniper and then climb and hop up the tree to where the suet feeder is, only to fly down and do it all again. In December and January, it was a visiting yellow-bellied sapsucker. I also really love the birds that our old friends had taught me long ago. The greater roadrunner, the common loon, and mountain bluebirds are just to name a few.
So what's my favorite bird? You know, that's a tough question, but I have to say it's the painted bunyip. When I was young and doing in grade school coloring birds, the painted bunting was the best bird to color because it had all the primary colors on it, the male did. It's a beautiful bird, it's got a beautiful song. The female is green and blends right into a bush. But I just love the painted birding. If God made a bird to show all the different colors of feathers, it was the painted bird. Bunting, I'm sorry, the painted bunting.
Well, I think every other month, my favorite bird changes, depending on, you know, the area, the environment. I really love the cedar waxwing. Yeah, what's your favorite bird, Rye?
Oh, I'm gonna have to go ahead and say the resplendent quetzal. I mean, it's such a gorgeous bird. I'll always remember the first time I saw it. It's just something that slaps you in the face.
My favorite bird right now is, I think, the greater roadrunner. And I say that because they remind me of dinosaurs, and I really like that. They're these like really interesting predators that can feed on like a wide variety of prey, from hummingbirds to rattlesnakes to mice and insects. And I just like the way they look. I like their hairdos and I like their long tails. I think they're pretty cool. I've only seen like three in my entire life, so.
What is my favorite bird? That's an impossible question. But I've always liked the American kestrel. Small but mighty is kind of my little phrase, and I just think they're kind of cool.